Okay, let's take a look at enantiomers. Enantiomers are a type of stereoisomer. We've been talking about isomers. There are two categories of isomers, constitutional isomers and stereoisomers. Constitutional isomers have the same formula, different order of bonding. Stereoisomers also have the same formula. I'll put this here. Also have the same formula, two stereoisomers do. They have the same order of bonding. So notice the difference. Constitutional isomers have a different order of bonding. Stereoisomers, the order of bonding is the same. What's different is the, what should we say, spatial arrangement. We could say that spatial arrangement of atoms. Or I could say what we mean by that is the direction in space the atoms point. I think we're better off seeing it by example, but let's at least try to define different direction in space that the atoms are pointing. We saw that just now with cis and trans. One pointing up, one pointing down, that was trans. Both pointing up or both pointing down, that was cis. So the direction things are pointing. That's what's different with stereoisomers. Now let's take a look at enantiomers. So enantiomers, as we said, are a type of stereoisomer. Let's take an introduction. We'll start out by saying this. Everything has a mirror image. This red pen has a mirror image. My finger has a mirror image. Everything has a mirror image. So every molecule has a mirror image. We'll just say that to start off. Every molecule has a mirror image. That's not interesting at all. That's not relevant or important or interesting. That's not what we care about. Here is what we do care about. What is interesting is this. Whether or not the molecule and its mirror image are identical to each other or different from each other. So a molecule will always have a mirror image. Sometimes the molecule and its mirror image are the exact same thing, and sometimes the molecule and its mirror image are different. So that gives us two questions. How do we know which is which? How do we know when they'll be identical, when they'll be different? And, you know, why do we care? Why is that interesting? Let's answer the first one first. Here's how you know. Here's how you'll know if a molecule and its mirror image are identical or different. First, we introduce this new word, chiral. It's pronounced like that, chiral. A chiral molecule is one that will be different from its mirror image. So if you know if a molecule is chiral, then you'll say, okay, that molecule is different from its mirror image. Achiral, and that means not chiral, an achiral molecule then will be identical to its mirror image. So chiral means they're different from each other. Achiral means the molecule and its mirror image are identical. So we want to know something about chiral molecules. We'll define it this way. A chiral molecule is a molecule that has a chiral carbon. If you look through that molecule and find at least one chiral carbon, then that makes the whole molecule chiral. And then, of course, we need to say, well, what does this mean? What is a chiral carbon? A chiral carbon is a carbon bonded to four totally different groups. Carbon always has four bonds. If the groups that those bonds go to are all four different from each other, that's what a chiral carbon is. And we'll see in the next video how to figure all that out. But I told you I would also explain why is this interesting? Why do we care if a molecule is different from its mirror image? Here's why. If you have a molecule that's different from its mirror image, you know, we said that's a chiral molecule. Those chiral molecules form a pair called enantiomers. We just said that the molecule and its mirror image, if they're different, in the case of chiral molecules, they are different. Since they are different, the molecule and its mirror image are a pair of isomers called enantiomer. It's the other type of stereoisomer. And here's why it's interesting. Your body can tell the difference. And that might not seem surprising right now, but when we show some examples, It's pretty amazing that the molecules, the only difference is that they're mirror images of each other. Your body will treat them in very different ways. Sometimes we'll see examples, medicines, for example, drugs, the two different pairs of the isomer, the two different members of the pair, one of them might be the thing that helps get rid of your headache and the other mirror image might do nothing. Or maybe one of the pairs of enantiomers might treat the symptom and the other one might cause kidney problems, examples like that. Your body knows the difference. Flavors would be different. A compound that tastes like lemon might be the mirror image of the compound that tastes like orange, for example. So this is very, very noticeable in your body. Your body treats those things differently. And in the next video, what we will do is take a look at some examples. How can you tell if a compound is chiral or achiral?